everyone, welcome back to my channel. And in this video we will be talking about a very small but a very important topic, that is slop rule. And it is one of the oldest and commonly used object localization technique in dentistry. So whenever there is any kind of foreign body or any kind of supernumerary tooth or an impacted tooth present in the oral cavity, or if you want to localize, you know, the position of any object in the jaws during that time, we use this object localization technique. So suppose we take a normal x-ray, suppose we take an anterior region radiograph and we see there's an extra tooth present. Now we don't know whether the tooth is present on the outside or it's present inside palatally. So कभी भी हम एक normal x-ray लेते हैं, जब देखते हैं कि यहाँ पे कोई एक tooth या you know कोई भी एक foreign body दिख रही है, तो हमको पता नहीं चलता कि वो बाहर की तरफ है, buccally located है या palatally located है. तो उस time we use the slop technique. So what is slop rule? So basically slop stands for same side lingual opposite buccal. How do we do it? So basically in slop technique we take two x-rays. So the first x-ray that we take is the x-ray that we take in normal horizontal and vertical angulation. So suppose if we are taking a maxillary canine x-ray, so what is the vertical angulation? We give plus positive 45 degree angulation, plus 45 degrees for canine, and horizontal angulation is 0. So that is the first x-ray that we take. Then we take another x-ray and now we can either shift the tube head horizontally or vertically. So basically when we shift the tube head horizontally, we can keep the same vertical angulation and we can just either shift the tube distally or we can shift the tube mesially. So that is your horizontal movement. Or what we can do is we can keep the same horizontal angulation that we had taken the x-ray initially in, and we can either shift the tube head, you know, vertically. That is, we can either increase the angulation like this or we can decrease the angulation. We can shift it downwards. So we can either shift it vertically or we can shift it horizontally. So whenever we move the tube horizontally, that is mesially or distally, or vertically, that is upwards or downwards, during that time, if the object to be localized moves in the same direction as that of the tube head with respect to the reference object, then it is said to be lingually located. And if it moves in the opposite direction, it is said to be buccally located. So when we are moving the tube distally, as you can see in this diagram, the tooth moves to the opposite side. So that means same side lingual opposite buccal. So that means the tooth is located buccally. Now the first x-ray that we see in the diagram is taken in the normal angulation. And when you see the second diagram, we moved the tube head distally and the tooth moved to the same side, which means the tooth is either located lingually or it is located palatally. So basically what happens in slop rule? So the objects that are closer to the film, they move less distance than the objects farther from the film. So whenever we move the tube head, the objects that are located closer to the film, they move less than the objects that are farther from the film. So let's see an example. So suppose this is your jaw, these are the teeth, and this is the object to be localized that we can see here. And this is the x-ray film. So we have taken first x-ray in the same vertical and horizontal angulation in which it is implicated. So this is the first x-ray that we have taken, and we can see the object is, you know, superimposed on the distal root of the first molar. Now we move the tube head mesially. So when we move the tube head mesially, what happens? Now the x-ray beam is directed distally. Can you see the direction of the beam? It is distal. So what happens now? The teeth as well as the object both will move on the film distally. Both will move distally. So when they move on the film, what happens? The object which is located closer to the film will move less. That is this object. So we have two things. The tooth is also moving and the object is also moving. But what is happening? The object is moving less on the film. So both the tooth and the object move on the film. Distally they move. They move on the distal side. But what happens? Because the tooth is farther from the film, it moves more than the object to be this object. So what happens? Now, as a result of that, because this has moved more and this has moved less, relatively it appears as if this has moved mesial to the tooth. This object has object to be localized has moved mesial to the tooth because both of them moved. So suppose this tooth moved more and this object has moved less. So it gives an appearance though. It gives an appearance as if it has moved mesial to the root. Can you see? Because this is the object was on the distal root. Now it appears as if the object has moved mesially. Whereas what has happened? Both have moved distally, but this has moved more on this side.
Tooth or object, दोनों ही film के ऊपर move करते हैं. But क्योंकि object जो है वो film के पास है और वो कम move करता है, इसलिए ऐसा लगता है कि object जो है वो mesially move हुआ है.
So what had happened? We had moved the tube head mesially, and the object also moved mesially. So it is located on the lingual aspect. That is, it is located nearer to the film. So similarly, suppose if the object was located on the buccal aspect, and we would have moved the tube head mesially, what would have happened that time? That time also the tooth and the object would have moved on the film distally. Suppose the object was here now, and since the tooth is nearer to the film now, the tooth would have moved lesser as compared to the object. The tooth would have moved less and the object would have moved farther. So it would have appeared that the object has moved to the opposite direction, has moved in the opposite direction, because now instead of being located here, it would have been superimposed on the distal root of the second molar. So then it would have appeared that the tube head has moved mesially, but the object of interest has moved distally. So basically it's a relative movement which is giving this appearance. And so that is how the slob rule works. So similarly it works in the vertical shift, whenever we shift the tube head vertically. So it is a very important technique when we are planning for any kind of surgery. Suppose impacted tooth nikalna hai, ya fir ortho ke liye we are planning to do the surgery and you know expose the tooth. So us time humko location pata hona chahiye ki tooth palatally located hai or if the tooth is located on the buccal aspect. So that brings us to the end of the video. So if you have any doubts and queries, since it's a very confusing topic, you can leave a message in the comment section below. And thank you so much for watching. Thank you.